our video. If you would like to download the free manual that follows along with this video, the link is in the description below. Now let's start adding logic. There's three phases to adding logic in my schedules. The first phase is going down through the individual group of activities that I've inserted within my WBS, and I build those as if they were individual schedules. That's one reason why I always keep small groups in my WBS. If I have more than 10 activities or so, I start looking at how to break my WBS out into another level and organize accordingly. So the first step, build the small schedules within the schedule. Let's do that first step. There's three ways to link activities. The first is my linking tool. When I move my mouse to the end of an activity, I get this linking tool. The odd thing about this linking tool is it's got an arrow on one end, but actually the mouse is pointing with the other. So I put the linking tool at the end of one activity and link it to the start of its successor. I'm going to do that again, linking these two activities together. Now you'll notice my schedule automatically calculated. I have my settings set for auto calculation using my tools, schedule, options, and the fourth checkbox down says schedule automatically when a change affects dates. I close that, hit schedule to save that setting, and my schedule will calculate automatically. Let's do just a couple more using our linking tool. I'm linking submittals to mobilization and mobilization to trailer setup and fencing. I have my activity set to sort by my activity ID column. That keeps my activity IDs in order as I'm adding my logic. Let's look at the second way to link activities. I can select more than one activity. I hold my control key, select another activity, edit, link activities. Notice it added a finish to start relationship with those activities. I can do more than just two. I can hold my shift key, highlight this entire section of activities, edit, link activities. Let's do a couple of more of those. I can actually right-click, and there's my link activities right there on my shortcut menu. I look at this next set of activities. They're all in order, so I hit right-click, link activities. So the first way to add relationships is using the linking tool. Second way is through edit link activities. Now, I have my relationships tab selected on the bottom, and that shows me my predecessors on the left, my successors on the right. I'm going to add some start-to-start relationships to my activities. My interior framing is going to start 2 days, and then my rough plumbing, rough mechanical, and rough electricals will add. Now, the advantage of using these windows down here at the bottom is I can add multiple relationships to one activity at one time. I select my assigned successors. By default, it goes to my interior framing since it's selected. I can use my control key to highlight all three of those, and it selects all three of those activities as successors. Down here in the bottom, I can customize these columns, make one smaller. I can also right-click and change the columns that are actually being displayed. I'm going to use my relationship column to change this to a start-to-start. Each one of these, and then I'm going to change the lag to 2 days for each one. You can see the relationships are overlapping. Issue that you want to make sure you address in dealing with start-to-start relationships is making sure that you have a finish relationship for each of these activities as well. Otherwise, there could be an indefinite finish restriction. So in this case, I'm going to add all four of these, my framing, plumbing, mechanical, and electrical, to my insulation as predecessors. So there's my insulation activities. There's all four of those activities. I select them and add those relationships to insulation. Once again, I'm building a small schedule with just these activities within this WBS element. And each one of these has a start and a finish activity. Those are the three ways I can add relationships to my schedule. In the next video, we'll give some tips and tricks for using these three methods.
Don't forget to like and subscribe, share with your colleagues, and leave a comment. We'll get back to you as soon as possible.